Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech DIY's playground session. This time we are playing around somewhat more with OpenAPI. In the previous session, we have defined one simple endpoint with hard-coded output. While in this session, we are going to see all the CRUD endpoints. We have used MongoDB as our data source, and to keep things simple, we are having blog use case as usual. So just like other sessions, this also is tier apart in three sections. Section 1, setup and configuration. Section 2, defining a schema specification in YAML file. Section 3, final demo. So at any point of time, you can jump across to section of your interest. So without further ado, let's get started. So here we have our YAML file. We are continuing with our previous project setup. The link can be found in description section, or on the I button you can see the link for the previous video where we have done the complete setup. And now here we in this pom.xml we are setting up the Mongo configurations, MongoDB configurations, and we need to add the Spring Boot Mongo support. So that's what we are doing here. Spring Boot starter MongoDB starter data MongoDB, I think that's what we, yeah, data MongoDB, that dependency we are adding here. And with that dependency, after adding that dependency, we need to, as usual, after updating any POM, we need to refresh the Maven. So we will do that Maven refresh again. And yeah, in application properties, we need to define the port as well as the, you know, DB name. So as I'm referring one of my previous project where I have done the configuration. So you can see that information. I will share that in this application property file also with you. So you can, you know, refer that for your playgrounds or your experiments. Okay, so yeah, that's it. And as you can see, this is what was generated earlier, and we had in earlier project or setup also we were doing blog. So here also we are having a blog schema. So in our we have updated the Maven, it seems that is updated now. So let's see if all things are fine after building. So yeah, now if we can see, like as we have seen earlier also in last section or in the previous video, that our OpenAPI generator will generate the code for us, and the controller part will be taken care by the generated code, and it will give a delegate handler to us, so we can implement that delegate handler and we can write our endpoints directly in the service layer. Okay, so with this approach, what we had done earlier also is that we have defined our schema file and then we have started our build, and build has generated the complete OpenAPI project for us. So the same thing we have done here also, and now we are defining the repository by hand and writing the service classes. So now I don't know why it is not importing the Mongo repository. It seems there is some problem. Ideally this alt enter should import the class if everything is fine, then. But wait a minute, in the pom.xml it is not there. The dependency which we have added is not there in this pom.xml of the project setup. Then okay guys, one mistake we have done, and that is that actually this OpenAPI generated code also has its own pom.xml, so we have copied our Mongo dependency into that pom.xml instead of our project's pom.xml. So please take care of this while you are also doing the experiment. Please take care of this. We need to copy into the project's setup, project's pom.xml. then only our libraries or our dependencies will work. Okay, so we are doing that again, and again we are refreshing Maven. And now if we see Mongo repository, now you can see it is imported properly, and in the repository we have written one method. This also we have taken earlier. Also we have seen, like, if we want to do in the repository, if we want to have in repository interface, if we want to have another find methods other than the ID, then we need to write at query and we need to define those methods. So that is what we have done there, and now that's what we are trying. So in our delegate method, in our delegate IMPL is the class which we are going to use for writing our own code, and the generated code has given this delegate handler to us, and we need to implement that handler, and that's what we have done. So blog API delegate handler is the one, and we are implementing that blog API delegate IMPL in the IMPL class. And whatever methods we want, we can do the generate part, and we can override the methods provided in that. Okay, so now we have started the server first for the first time, and we are just trying to hit it. But wait a minute, I think it is hitting, but the thing is no, it is not hitting in the data, in the database it is not having records. So this DB, whatever I'm showing, is previous DB. So I'm just clearing it out, trying to insert one, and then we'll try to fetch it from here. If that won't work, I will make another I'll make another endpoint for create, and then we will see create and fetch or find by ID or find by title together in the coming section. So let's before that, let's try. So we are trying to, this is MongoDB Compass, and in Compass we have connected to database which we will be referring, and we are trying to insert, but it is not allowing, insertion is not happening. So one thing, if we want to insert from here, we need to tell the class name also. Okay, if we want to insert a document in through MongoDB Compass, so in this structure we need to define the ID, all properties, and the class name, full class name with our package details also. So that is what we have tried here. Okay, ID, title, content, class, these 3-4 things we are defining here. And insert, but insert is not happening, it seems. But let's see. Okay, so we are adding, you might have observed, we have added Lombok here in the project. We already had a Lombok, so we are making use of Lombok also now here. We are having the Lombok annotation at SLF4j for having the SLF4j into the class info logs. And other than that, we are having all our constructor also here, and we are following one best practice, which is instead of directly auto wiring into the setters, this time we are doing the auto wiring to constructor. And you might not be able to see the code there, but it is happening because we have used the Lombok annotation at all our constructors. So all our constructor, what it does is it takes all the final objects there and initializes them. Yeah, so that is what is done there. And now we are writing the service layer here. As you can see, we have written one blog service which is having all the CRUD operations, and this blog service impl or IMPL, this class is going to define all the methods like create, find by ID, update, delete. Those methods we are going to have, that code we are going to have here, and this would require blog repository to be auto wired into this. So that also we are doing through the constructor of this blog service impl. And yeah, so now we have annotations, Lombok annotations into our code in place. So you can see whatever the code is actually needed, that is only present in the in here, and which is not needed or unnecessarily boilerplate code is removed, and the code is much readable here. So find by title, ideally find by title, what we will do is find by title method is returning a list of blog objects, and inside this it is returning blog repository dot find by title. You remember we have written this query wherein we are passing one parameter, expecting one parameter, which is blog title. And once blog title is available, we will be able to fetch all the blogs which that particular with that particular title. Here we have for multiple column editor we also have used. So I will provide the shortcut for that also. That's the magic of IntelliJ, and even in Eclipse also it is there. Yeah, so now delete we will be doing by ID, and find we will be doing by title, create we will be doing by just passing the blog object of, and for update also we will pass the whole blog object. So the case here is if the blog is already available, then it will update that blog. If the blog is not available, it will create that blog. So same endpoint, only different is the type of method. Okay, so that is what we are going to have here. As you guys might already know, I'm considering a fresher would be seeing this video. So we have four methods for all the CRUD operations in HTTP. First is get, put, post, and delete. These are the main methods you would be playing around most of your time in Spring, while writing Spring Boot microservices. Okay, so post will be used to post the data, that is create the data. Put will be used to update the data. Get will be used to get some data from server or get the resources from server. So, and delete, as its name suggests, delete would be, we will be telling this, guiding the server to delete some particular resource. Okay, so that's what we are going to do there. We are opening editor Swagger. Yeah, this also, this link will help you in writing the specification YAML. We also have referred this. For writing the other endpoints, earlier we have only one endpoint, that is blogs/blog title. And now we are writing the other endpoints, yeah. And in the left side, I have opened Swagger editor. In the right side, I have opened my own YAML file. Swagger editor has one good example of this patch store. So in the same lines, I'm also trying to develop my own endpoints. So my first endpoints is blog/blog titles, get. And it will be referring this items under this, since we will be getting the items array in the response. So we will be having, we need to, item array of blog type. So we are telling the type, and then we are referring our blog object in the schema. We are referring to components, schemas, blogs. Okay. Yeah, so other endpoints, we, as I said earlier also, we will be having /blog, and under /blog we, our operation ID would be create or create post. So I'm just naming it as created blog or create blog, or yeah, and defining the another method, that is put. Yeah, so as you can see here in the patch store also, they are having these attributes for the /blog path. So that is what we are defining here. Our method would produce application JSON. Parameters are ID, or in our case it is title, so we will give title here. Okay. As you can see in the left side, left side we are having, this is the post method, this is the post path structure. So we will follow this one, and we have followed that and we have defined those paths. Don't worry if you are not able to see it properly. I will provide this schema.yaml for it will be available at the shared location in, and the link would be as usual will be provided in the video description section. Okay, so there seems to be some problem. Most of the time YAML file would have problem related to indentation. Let's see what kind of problem this time it would be saying. So it's saying blog post parameters body one. Okay. We need to be very, very careful because while fixing this annotations problem. And this, shortcut for column mode would be on Mac. It is Shift Command 8. On Windows, it is Alt Shift Insert. So it will take you to the column editing mode, and you can, this indentations and these issues you can easily fix with column mode. Okay. So yeah. So again, I'm trying to do that, fixing the indentations in YAML file, and now it seems okay. Let's run it again. The problems which I faced while writing this doing this code are mostly indentation related one, and the reference there, I mean in the Swagger editor's pet store reference was good enough for me, and with that I was able to generate my project code, I mean the controller and that stuff, I was able to generate with that reference. So yeah, and here we are having slash blog. Blog title, in blog titles response we will be having array of blogs, because with one title there can be, in our scenario with one title there can be multiple blogs also, so that's why we kept it like that. And and in this path for blogs, we, as I told earlier, we will be having two slash blog path. One is for put method and other is for post method. So here we are writing the post one, and for post also we would be passing the body in the request. So that's why we need to define those things here. Name and body, in the name we are passing the body part. And actual body would be present in our component section, component schema blogs. So that reference we have added here in the $ref of that path. And yeah, this is the Swagger documentation I have used. Don't worry, I will add this link also in description section, so you may go over it. And if you stuck somewhere, you can go over that and you can identify your resolve your problems. Okay, so yeah. So in this case, in this post method, how it will behave? It will behave like this. If the create is successful, we will be getting 200 okay as a response status. If it fails, then we will get bad request. So those things we have written in the schema, and those are generated there. As you can see here, so our post method is fine now, and now we are generating the code, I mean generating the, overriding the create method. And guys, actually I have copied the slash post part and updated that, so that's why I have not I forgot to define the operation, API operation. So the generator, what it has done is it took the path and it took the method name, and it has created the name blog post for operation, API operation. Anyway, we can use it for our purpose. But yeah, while writing a schema file, if you don't define API operation, then it will behave like this. So please remember this while writing a schema. Please give the open API, API operation ID, you should properly give. Okay, because after that only that would be the handler for us in service layer, in delegation layer also. Okay, so that we need to do, and we are just trying to hit it for the first time, just defining one blog object here in the postman, passing that as a request body, in passing that in request body, and trying to hit the service. Ideally, if everything is fine, it should save this data into MongoDB, our data source. Okay, it seems it's not started. So let's start it again. So now the server is coming up, server is bouncing. And server is started at port number 8081. And as you can see, while hitting, first when we click on send, our request is saved in the DB. And it says again, target 100k subs as the blog title. So yeah, again we are saying target 100k subs. So guys, please make it a reality. So as you can see, one more thing guys, actually while doing the MongoDB configuration, we haven't written the MongoDB configuration class or the configuration class separately. So that's why what it is doing is it is giving the our application is while running, starting up, it is just creating test as a database, default database, and putting our data there instead of MongoDB configuration. You can refer our previous videos for the configuration file, okay, or I will paste a generic one there in with this video, with this sample code also. Okay, so now you can see we are able to hit create, we are able to hit find. So both find and create are fine now. We are able to write blog and we are able to find them. And since logs are there, so we are able to see the logs also for both the endpoints. And now we will move ahead and we will write the remaining ones. So for put part, now comes the put part. So put will be almost similar as create only. So we have just duplicated the create part and we have renamed the tag name we have changed from post to put, and the remaining part is same. And for delete also, you can refer these endpoints, this code in the YAML file which will be present in the sample code location. Okay, so you can have a look there. And if, as you guys might be aware, that Data JPA or Spring Data API, what it does is it this repository, right? Whenever we write a repository, so the repository interface will take care of having all the methods like find, save, delete, find all those methods are defined there in that API itself. So we are good with that. We don't need to do anything at that layer. Only thing we need to do here is writing the delegate, writing the service in service layer also, handling over to the repository API for saving, for deleting, for all the CRUD operations basically. And as you can see in the demo, now we are having all the four operations. We are trying all of them and all of them are happening in the DB, we can, and reflecting in the DB as well. Yeah, so these are the things we have tried today. And thanks for your patience. Thanks for being with me. Thanks for watching and support us in reaching to target 100k subscribers. Please like, share and subscribe. Press the bell icon to get prompt notification. Until next playground session, enjoy life, stay safe, stay at home and keep learning. Bye.